This video explains how to use CRP5 to calculate true airspeed above 300 knots, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comments section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the 8th video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. Airspeed indicators give you indicated airspeed based on the dynamic pressure, which usually written as Q. Dynamic pressure equals half density multiply with velocity squared. If we transpose this formula, we can get the speed. However, this speed is not true airspeed. This is because the airspeed indicator is calibrated to International Standard Atmosphere ISA density at sea level 1125 gram per meter cube. As you might have learned before, as altitude increase, density will reduce. At any other density other than ISA density at sea level, compressibility effects start to occur. Compressibility is not prominent for true airspeed below 300 knots. However, compressibility correction needs to be applied for true airspeed above 300 knots. To apply compressibility correction, we need to use the compressibility correction window on CRP5, which is highlighted in red on the screen. An example will make the operation clear. We are at flight level 350, the static air temperature is minus 47 degrees Celsius, and the CAS is 265 knots. What is the true airspeed? Start by converting CAS to TAS in the usual ways. First step. In the airspeed window, set flight level 350 against minus 47 degrees Celsius. Next, find 265 knots on the inner scale. Now, read off the answer on the outer scale. You should get 473 knots TAS. 473 knots is well above 300 knots. Thus, compressibility correction needs to be applied. So, how do we apply the compressibility correction? Under the compressibility correction window, there is a formula, TAS divide by 100 minus 3 divisions. Thus, we need to divide the initial TAS by 100 and subtract 3. This gives us 1.73 divisions. Now in the compressibility correction window, move the index arrow 1.73 divisions to the left. It is not easy to judge this to the second decimal place, but try to be as accurate as possible. You have moved the inner scale to the left, altering the relationship between CAS and TAS, correcting it for compressibility. Now read the new value of TAS on the outer scale, against 265 on the inner scale. The revised TAS is 457 knots. This is the final answer, and this is how you correct for compressibility error. In the next video in this video series, we will discuss on Mach number. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.